Good morning, I'm Mark Champion, Q105 Sports. 162 games and 6 games in the playoffs. And it all comes down to one game, and that's tonight. The New York Mets and Los Angeles Dodgers tied at 3 games apiece. The Mets with a win last night 5-1, a 5-hitter by David Cone. Kevin McReynolds 4-for-4, including a 2-run homer. He knocked in 3 runs on the night. Oral Hershiser and Ron Darling will be the pitchers in Game 7 tonight at Dodger Stadium. The San Diego Chargers gave up future considerations to get Napoleon McCallum, who is still in the Navy. He was with the Los Angeles Raiders at one time, but McCallum will be put on the special reserve military list by the San Diego Chargers. Ray Perkins says he may well activate Don Smith, the running back who has been on IR for about a year and a half. We'll have details coming up in the cage.
Tampa Bay weather.
Good morning, Q105 Bay Area forecast. Not bad, huh? A little cold front over Georgia tries to move in to the Bay Area here tonight. Ahead of the front today, lots of sunshine, but with a high at 82. Tonight, fair skies cooling down to 59. And then for tomorrow and Friday, sunny skies, cooler with highs in the upper 70s. In our beach and boating forecast, winds out of the west to southwest today under 10 miles an hour, with gulf waves 2 to 3 feet. Today's tanning index 7 on a scale of 10. I'm meteorologist Ellen Archer, watching our Suncoast and Bay Area weather for Q105.
Right now it's 60 degrees in Orlando, also in Sarasota, 61 in Lakeland, 66 St. Pete, Clearwater, 60 now Tampa, and at 7:05 I'm Pat Brooks for Q105.
You're listening to Cleveland Wheeler and Friends on America's original Q Morning Zoo on WRBQ FM Tampa and WRBQ AM St. Petersburg. Q105, Tampa Bay's radio station.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand by. Should crumble to the sea. I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me.
Stand by me. Whenever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh,
QZoo in the morning, 8 minutes past 7 o'clock. Cleveland and friends on the radio here. It's 60 degrees right now. Tampa, Sarasota, Bradenton, 60. Lakeland, 61. St. Peter's, Water, and Clearburg at 66. Orlando reporting it at 60. And our tanning index, a 7. Matter of fact, mostly sunshine today. The Weather Service said about, to what, 70 or 75% sunshine today. We have no answer in the trivia question, and I'll tell you what's stumping people up. It's not necessarily the size of the shoe by number. It is the width of the shoe. You must know the width, too. I mean, that has a lot to do with it. When you go in to order your own shoes, you don't just say, a 9.5, please. It's either, if you've got a very narrow foot, it's like a 9.5E, or, you know, when we get water, C, D, whatever. So you get into that part of it also. It's 8 minutes past 7 o'clock at your QZoo in the morning, and find a gym. I would suggest you head back to this throne room in a couple of seconds here.
Talk about stress in Tampa Bay area.
Because a lot of folks are already on the line here. We got teachers on the phone this morning, and some parents of students here talking about, well, I'll tell you what causes stress. It's that dean, that principal of that school.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
But actually, we'll hear from teachers as to why they think there's very much more stress on students here, especially in the past couple of years. All right?
Okay.
Head on back there and let's hear it. Jim Reilly is in the throne room this morning talking about the new Psychology Today survey. And it shows, of course, that Tampa, Florida, on this survey, is the 19th most stressful curriculum, 19th most stressful school system in the United States, along with Clearwater and St. Petersburg. They lump those three municipalities all together.
Do you find life in the Bay Area stressful? I don't find life in Tampa Bay stressful. Well, next month's issue of Psychology Today finds life in Tampa Bay stressful, even more stressful than life in the New York City area. Whoa, right there it is on the front page of the Tampa Bay State section of the San Pedrosburg Times this morning. Bay Area stress level near the top. Ooh, this survey checked metro areas in this country for stressful psychological factors, economic, climatic, educational, cultural, and finds Reno, Nevada to be the worst. Miami, FLA, number 3, Jacksonville, 8, Fort Lauderdale, 12, Orlando, 15, Tampa, Clearwater, St. Petersburg, 19th most stressful, New York, 20. Least stressful, State College, Pennsylvania, 1, Rochester, Minnesota, 4, Sheboygan, Wisconsin, 11, Lawrence, Kansas, number 20. And my first question is, if them other places are so great, how come everybody from State College, Rochester, Sheboygan, Lawrence is moving to Tampa, Clearwater, St. Petersburg? Second question, how stressful was your last 24 hours? Mine involved a drive up the Dale Mabry to the Nutrisystem on Fletcher where I couldn't keep an appointment, talking a few times to the news director over Channel 10 about calling one of their stories the other night insensitive, having a drunk come up to my car window at Fowler in Nebraska yesterday afternoon asking for 93 cents, and trying to get my lawn watered last night. I'm fairly new here. I really like this place and its people. And about the only thing I find real stressful is reading Psychology Today reports on how stressful this place is supposed to be. Like Maggie Thatcher said to Leslie Stahl one interview, "Lighten up, honey." From the throne room, I'm Jim Reilly.
Yeah, we'll learn you anyway.
And now, a message from the QZoo Learn to Talk course.
How many times have you gone to an expensive French restaurant and heard this? And you weren't sure what to say? Well, never again when you enroll in a Burlisp Learn at Home Lisping course. Yes, now you too can learn to lisp in any language with Burlisp. Amaze your friends the next time you're in a French restaurant and you order like this. Yes, at Burlisp, you'll learn to lisp in any language you choose, like German.
How about this China brief and also Deutsch?
Spanish.
Come on, let's go to Toluca Lake, man.
Russian.
Yes, less scrawly, but solely fits a rams.
Even pig Latin.
Ich pay Latin lacy is Arlite.
Call Burlisp today. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-344-6474. That's 1-800-344-6474. Call today.
Or call QZoo.
Crockett and Tom.
Well, how about some freshly sliced cold cuts or maybe seafood and crabs, steak and cheese? I make every Subway sandwich fresh.
I can't make up my mind.
Hot from the oven, white or whole wheat, I bake them fresh.
I can't make up my mind.
Subway sandwich?
Or Subway salad.
We bake them fresh. We make them fresh. Everybody loves Subway subs.
I've made up my mind. Just give me the works.
Where were you born?
I was born in East L.A., man.
I was born in East L.A., man. I was born in East L.A.
Help! I've been deported. I'm in Tijuana.
Why don't you take off your pants?
Passports, green cards.
Cheech Marin.
Rocket scientist, huh?
Sacramento, give this man a rubber tortilla.
Hey, man, I was born in East L.A., okay?
I feel good. Ow!
It doesn't have to be like this. Children raised in violent homes learn violence there. Our children shouldn't have to pay the price. Call the Spring in Tampa.
Around the world in 30 minutes, this is Headline News.
From the company that created CNN, the Headline News Network. Watch your watch, then watch business news 8 minutes into every half hour.
It's time now for Headline Business News. On Wall Street today, the market closed at a new high.
Watch the Headline News Network 8 minutes into every half hour for the latest business news. Business news on Headline News, always on time.
Past 7 o'clock, and we go up in the sky to Nancy Alexander with traffic for you.
Well, we had a group of folks take us up on our invitation. They were sitting around the sinkhole at Armenia in Hillsboro and somehow moved it to the other Florida choice at Candy to the west of McDill. In other words, I'm tapped at dancing around the fact that we goofed. It's at the south end of town along Candy Boulevard to the west of McDill. Watch for a great big hole in the roadway sooner or later.
Let's propose that Nancy doesn't know her traffic from a hole in the ground, right?
Okay, 21st Street and 2nd Avenue, southbound traffic affected by a collision there. Overall traffic volume is very, very heavy on Hillsborough Avenue, southbound Sheldon and Anderson. And we also have some patchy ground fog in north and northeastern Hillsborough County, so do watch for that. Uncle Arch has what's happening on the big bridges.
Just passed over those big bridges, took a look at the Howard Franklin, which is very heavy eastbound, needless to say. The Gordon Campbell, the Gandy, all moving along very well. Over Pinellas County, a couple of problems reported by Deputy Mike.
Had a chance to check on an accident with injuries in the Largo area, Indian Rocks Road, a half a mile north of Walsingham. A lot of emergency activity on the scene. The accident itself is in the northeast corner. A minor collision at 58th Avenue and 34th Street. That is blocking the right lane northbound. Already very heavy volume, especially U.S. 19 southbound between Nursery and Roosevelt. Over St. Petersburg, Deputy Mike for the Tire Kingdom Go Patrol.
Hey, how about the Mets? Yeah! How about the Mets? How about the Mets, anyway?
Night Train Lane and Mark Champion were just about as down to the dumps as Ray Perkins on a bad morning this morning.
What's a good morning for Ray? Anyway,
we'll get to that later, but the Mets. Whoa,
here's Spud McKenzie. Ladies and gentlemen, he's so excited also.
Spud McKenzie recording session. Take me out to the ball game. Take one.
Cut!
Spud McKenzie, take two.
Cut, cut, cut!
Somebody please put Spuds back on the chair. Thank you. Take three.
Cut!
Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. Rise and shine with folks like you. Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. Get up with the Morning QZoo. Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. They're America's original too. Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. Get up with the Morning QZoo. Get up in the morning, get up in Tampa. Get up with the Q Morning Zoo.
QZoo in the morning. Robert Palmer, 20 minutes past 7 o'clock, Cleveland and Friends on the radio here. And is there a UFO cover-up? Some believe there has been for quite some time, since the 40s anyway. Some people will talk to us tomorrow about those things. They are experts in the field. As a matter of fact, Channel 28 is having a special on Friday night just about this very subject. and about people with those encounters.
About 20 years ago in radio, when I got started, I did a special on UFO in Jackson, Mississippi after one sighting, and you wouldn't believe how many people saw UFOs after that special.
After the special, they all came out of the woodwork,
don't
they?
All came out of the woodwork. It was amazing. And I have come to believe that some people do see something weird, and as soon as it's reported, a whole bunch of people see something weird.
Well, you know, the power of suggestion is a mighty thing out there. And, of course, there are strange things in the skies. As a matter of fact, Shauna Stevens was saying she was coming to work the other morning. And, of course, it's pitch dark when we come to work. And along about South Mobley and Gunn Highway, a meteorite fell to the ground in that area. I mean, right in front of her car, you know, goes into the field next to her. So you can see strange things that you don't see every night in the sky.
Of course, that was a night after she come back from Chippendales, I believe.
That's right. She was seeing lots of things. Anyway, this is showing this place is squeal a good house creeping. By the way, you want to find out more about radon gas, and there is radon gas, to be sure. Not that kind of gas, no. The folks at Home Depot are concerned that everyone in the Tampa Bay area has a safe and secure and healthy home to live in. And to lend credibility, of course, we will look at a couple of articles here. In September 26th, the most recent article in Newsweek magazine says house improvements and the risk from radon health article in Newsweek magazine. Fortunately, dangerous radon levels are very easy to detect and possible to reduce. There are two main means of detection, both of which involve placing a small collector in the house for days to months and then having a lab measure the radon buildup. The initial testing cost is $10 to $50, and strategies for reducing the radon in contaminated homes range from improving ventilation to piping the radon-laden air out from under the foundation, which can cost as much as $2,500. The people at Home Depot can save you a lot of money on that procedure in itself and tell you what to
They've
do there.
They've got a kit, right?
And they have a kit to detect the radon gas level in your home if it is indeed present there. It is invisible, odorless, and virtually undetectable gas that seeps into your foundation, and levels in some areas of the country are high enough to be the equivalent of smoking 5 to 10, even 20 packs of cigarettes a day.
Whoa.
With the same tragic cancerous effects. Unfortunately, there are 7 Home Depot stores, and they have the radon test kits right now, the Rad Track kits for you to put in your house.
Did you read the story about the chemist who turns gas into diamonds?
No, I haven't read
that. Diamonds?
Yeah, that's in the paper this morning. That's right. Here we go. Here, a U.S. Navy chemist has found a way to convert sewer gas into diamonds.
He went into Mason's house and found 25 diamonds.
Now, at Mason's out, it'd be zirconite, or what is the name of that stuff?
No.
What is it?
Zirconia is in his ass, I guess. 23 past 7 o'clock. Don't know where those things come from. I'd hate to venture into that. A lot of comments on the telephone this morning here about our education system being one of the most stressful, and that is not according to us. That is not according to the speculation of some out there who might consider themselves under stress because of the education system or their kids to be. But certainly we have a high suicide rate in this area, and we're talking about the Tri-City area of Clearwater, St. Petersburg, and Tampa. And Psychology Today verifies that there is a lot of stress in the system by placing us 19 on the list in the nation of the most stressful school systems. And so we have some comments from people on the phone right now. Hello.
Oh, I'm kind of nervous. I've never been on the radio before.
Oh, that's okay. It's just like being on the toaster or the toilet.
I'm so ticked off about this in school that I'm just really hyper.
Well, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of stuff in the paper relating to education this morning. That's one of the things, of course, that came out of Psychology Today. The other thing is that thing that's happening in Hernando County about the school system putting bad kids in an isolation box. You seen that? That's lovely. No, really, they're putting them in a big, like a refrigerator box. Most kids like to be in one, except during school. They're kind of embarrassed to be put inside a big refrigerator box for being bad.
Humiliating.
Yeah, it is.
Get away with that.
I don't know. Well, I guess they're not. Now it's being called to the superintendent's attention there, and I guess he's supposed to stop it pretty soon.
Well, my griefs aren't quite that bad, but...
Yeah, what's wrong?
Well, since the first day of school over at Blake Junior High, we always like to take our kids to school. They enjoy it the first day, and so do we. We get to see the school and some of the teachers. And we were outside and waiting, watching the kids disembark from the buses and stuff. And we're sitting on the benches with our child. And the dean comes out, of course, showing authority to all these new junior high kids.
Was he wearing his jack boots?
No.
Okay.
Anyway, he comes and he starts yelling at the kids immediately.
Yeah.
Crowding in the walkway. And instead of explaining to them, young ladies and gentlemen, there's a patio area for you all if you'd like to, you know, move to this area. and wait for the bell, because we're all crowding up in here. Well, he immediately starts yelling at them, telling them, move, move! Y'all are crowding this area!
Wait a minute, I think he's coming right now. There he is, right there. Oh, come on in, sir.
Hi,
Dad. Yes, the dean is back. Well, certainly. Thank you, sir. Certainly, a lot of kids experience stress through the dean, but I don't think we're talking about that kind of stress. We're talking about academic stress, and this is just one of the many stresses which are indicated in this study in psychology today. It is not all centered on education, but that is one of the most stressful areas.
Well, you got climate in there. I mean, how stressful is Central Florida climate?
Yeah.
I mean, hey.
And we got a pretty good climate here. I can deal with the climate. There's no stress there. No snow to plow through in the morning or whatever. Got to find out about this educational stress, though. It's a very, very important part of this whole survey that was done. 26 minutes past 7 o'clock here at your Q Morning Zoo.
The best time on TV this fall. Catch the brightest leading ladies on HBO with stars like Cher.
I think I have really terrific fans. I mean, to be a Cher fan is like being a Jet fan.
As a public defender in Suspect, Cher proves to be a major performer.
I'm your lawyer. Anything you tell me is confidential. If you don't talk to me, I can't help you.
No, I've gotten to do some of the things that I've wanted to do, and it's been really difficult.
Jim, you want
to
let me out of here?
As one of the sexy witches of Eastwick, Cher proves her own independence.
All right, I've had it with you two, okay?
She's soft and as tough as nails.
You're not even interesting enough to make me sick.
Her qualities as a star performer shine through.
Would you like to be on the top or the bottom?
Goodbye, Daryl, and thank you for a lovely lunch.
Well, if that's the way you feel about it, that's the way you feel about it.
Cher's most recent work won her an Academy Award.
If we're going to have it, let's have it all.
I basically just do what it is that I feel is the right thing to do.
The brightest stars, the biggest hits, HBO, the best movies.
Hey, don't tell the radio audience, but we here at the QZoo Tube have a deal for you, our crazy viewers. We want you to be on the QZoo Tube. That's right, on the QZoo Tube. Send in a crazy photograph of yourself that will appear on the Crazy Viewer Hall of Fame. But that's not all. 200 pictures picked at random will receive admittance to the first annual Crazy Viewer Party at the only place that's in fashion, Penrod's. 5 runner-ups will receive dinner for two at the fun place with a serious kitchen, Penrod's. The grand prize winner will escape for 3 days and 2 nights to the romance of gondolas drifting past Victorian gazebos at Tampa Bay's First Choice Beach Hotel, the fabulous Trade Winds. To qualify, you must include your name, address, phone number, age, and when you watch the QZoo Tube. Send all entries to QZoo Tube Crazy Viewers, 5512 Gray Street, Suite 115, Tampa, Florida, 33609. Hurry, contest ends soon.
Hi, this is Jimmy Bepper.
This is Jimmy Carter.
If your name is Jim, you can win.
What?
At the Welcome Jim Party. Join Jim Reilly and his main attraction.
His big German butt!
Friday, October 14th at the Brandon Balloon Festival. From 5 to 6 p.m. during Mason's Friday live broadcast.
Whoopee.
The first 105 people named Jim who stop by will get a free QZoo Hello, My Name is Jim t-shirt.
Hi, this is Mason Leroy Dixon. Yeah, I was thinking of changing my name to Jim just so I get a new shirt.
Just call him Angel of the Morning. Jim Reilly on the Q Morning Zoo.
Thank you.
QZoo in the morning, 7:34, 26 minutes. We've made a clock. Cleveland and friends on the radio here, and we've got traffic information coming for you in a couple of seconds. Here's bad out there. Sinkholes and all kinds of bad stuff here on this fine hump day. And the way you win your George Michael tickets this hour here is I'm going to put the challenge out to you because nobody has got an answer on this trivia question.
I can't believe nobody knows what olive oil. Nobody knows what olive oil shoe size is? Come on.
Olive oil shoe size. Bill Connolly knows he's got it written down in his wallet along with some other things.
People are getting the number right, but not the width.
You got to have the width of her shoe. Now, this is documented, so we're not making this up here. And this is how you win your George Michael concert tickets right here at Q Morning Zoo this hour. We have some more coming up next hour and the hour after that. George Michael concert tickets every hour this morning. Also, we'll add a deposit into the First Florida free money account this morning after 9 o'clock when Bobby Rich comes in here and joins the zoo. All right, we got a special guest in here in uniform. Come on up, step up microphone, sir.
Come on down.
Thank you.
Gentleman's from the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office, and he is also from the Sotoma Club, right?
Right. Cleveland, Wheeler, and friends, in appreciation for your community service, last year, me being the district governor for Tampa Bay West District, we'd like to give you this nice plaque.
Man, thank you very much. I mean, that's the biggest plaque I think I've ever had.
Is that right?
I can see myself.
Yeah, that's a problem with mine. That's nice. Thank you very much,
Steve. A lot of people in this community just don't realize the impact that you all have, and maybe just a few minutes or the little time that you devote on the air to the community. And we really appreciate your time and effort. I've even known that you've reached in your pocket and paid for some activities. And Cleveland, we just appreciate you.
Well, thank you very much, Steve. I'm proud to accept this on behalf of the whole crew here because everybody gets out there and about, and oftentimes we do so. I say not we do so much as a stroke of pat on the back, but a lot of people in this office do so much that we can't mention on the radio.
Right.
Shauna gets out there, and Bill gets out there, and Jim, and they all get out for the community behind the microphone. So this is for them also.
It's not much, but I hope you display it somewhere in your office.
Can I put it in my car, man?
Yeah.
Come on.
In the back window, right?
Cleveland has never received an award from anybody with nicer hair. Now, those of you folks without the zoo tube.
Don't you think he has nice hair, huh?
We have a gentleman here. Right. I mean, how do you get your hair so nice?
Well, I use the Bob Height hairspray. I ordered that.
Polyglycol. That's right.
Many years ago, and it still works. I only used it one time, and 5 years later, it's still working. Unbelievable.
It's got a brush with a Steve Nistel Bristol.
Thanks Steve.
A lot, guys.
I appreciate that. It's 7:36. There's traffic. Nancy, what's going on?
Unfortunately, there's a lot of people getting hurt out here this morning. Gun Highway and Sugar Mill. There's a busy spot for you. An injury accident there, another one at George Road and Memorial, and that's really bad news because traffic was already lined up from Hillsborough Avenue all the way over to Independence. That's just going to slow it down even further. A head-on collision on Tampa East Boulevard to the west of Highway 301. We're going to try and get a look at that in just a moment. Traffic on 275 South is standing still, coming over Fowler Avenue. Does break up just a bit once you make it past Hillsborough. And then, of course, we have the famous moving sinkhole. It has come to rest on Gandy Boulevard to the west of MacDill, so watch out for that. Deputy Mike has a look at the big bridges.
Right now, over the Howard Franklin Bridge, it is clear in both directions with moderate to heavy volume. Courtney Campbell on the Gandy looking good. Here's Arch Deal with a check on Pinellas County.
And what a long lineup of traffic down US 19, or Useless 19 this morning. It comes to a big halt at Drew, picks up again. Then it stretches from Bel Air all the way down to East Bay. It'll take some patience to get through there. Wrapping up an accident right now to Wilcox and Indian Rocks Road. That's just about a half a mile north of Walsingham. A little bit over to the side at 58 Avenue North and 34th Street. Over the traffic, Arch Deal for the Tire Kingdom Go Patrol.
Must be a big backup of doctors there. He said take a lot of patience to get through there. It's 7:38 right here at the Q Morning Zoo. Good morning on my Brooksville line. Who is this?
Yes, I'm a teacher with the school system.
Yeah, you're in Sarasota. Sorry about that. Yes.
Yes, and I understand stress very much, and I feel that the students are under stress because the teachers in Florida State and on a whole are under stress.
And why is that?
Well, I believe it happened because Florida was in a hurry to upgrade its reputation.
Mm-hmm.
And if they developed what was called minimum standard skills testing, state assessment test. And the teachers are under such pressure to have the students pass the test that the students then receive the pressure underneath them. It's no different than your employer.
Yeah.
If your superiors are under stress, then the employees feel it.
So we're trying hard to catch up here because, I lived in Jacksonville and I lived in Daytona Beach back in 1966. And at that time when I lived in Daytona Beach, I ran into a couple of people who had moved from Jacksonville to Daytona who told me that at that time, most of the schools in that area were not accredited schools. and did not become accredited until 1968, something like that.
That's correct, and that's... I feel that Florida feels that, especially in our area. However, to be proud of minimum skills is not necessarily good. Up north, where I was a teacher for 10 years, we didn't feel the high anxiety because we were treated as professionals without having to be on the defense with what we did in the classroom. If we made an educational decision, we were treated as professionals and our decision was taken upon and acted on an individual basis. Here, it seems like the teachers have to be so pressured into these testing and so on that every move they make that they have to be accounted for to the point where people are afraid to even go on and do individual things.
I understand.
Students are feeling the stress in the test. I really can see it. And I'm not the only teacher that sees that. I wish that they would get away from the testing and let us use the skills in a meaningful ways for students.
All right. I have a friend who is at a local junior high school who has a class of 40 new students. Mm-hmm. And in that class of seventh graders, only three have reading skills above 75.
Right. Well, this is a transit area. Let's not forget that.
Yeah.
That many of these students have not been able to go to the same school throughout their educational life, like it happens up north so often. And so these students, we've had students in our classroom who have been to five, seven different schools in one school year. And then when they come in, it's very hard for a teacher to diagnose what their problem is and follow through. That's one of the problems, is because of the transit area. Another is that you have some of the problems with the migrants who are pulled out of school for so long.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really a difficult situation. I think that the school system is trying to help these people, but when you miss school and you miss the instruction, it can hurt the whole system.
What school system are you teaching in right now?
Sarasota.
In Sarasota. Thanks a lot for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
All right. Good morning. Hello, QZoo. How you doing? Hello there, QZoo.
Hi. I wanted to ask you two things, and one of them was about that news release. You said you were going to try to dig it up.
Which one was that? I got so many people on the phone, I can't remember.
Okay, that was about the mysterious ray, and I thought it was almost a hoax, and you said absolutely not, that it came over the wire and it was supposed to be legitimate?
No, it was legitimate. It came out. It was on all newspapers. I remember that very day. It was a big story in the St. Petersburg Times on it. There was one in USA Today. It's a mystery ray, which is coming from somewhere in outer space, far, far, far away. And the gist of the story was that the scientists were not concerned with necessarily where it was coming from, emanating from, but how much volts of energy that it carried, so they could harness the ray and use it for something, probably perhaps like bombs or nuclear power plants or something like that. They weren't thinking in the direction that most people were going. Wow, mystery ray. Wonder what planet that's coming from and why it's beaming to Earth.
We have a mystery ray on every Monday morning.
As a matter of fact, that we got a mystery ray tuned in right here.
You know, I wouldn't want to get into what positions and all.
No, that's a different mystery ray, though. No, that's not the one. It's not a hoax, though. It's as a matter of fact, I can't quote because I don't have the story right here before me, but it had something like 4 quadrillion volts of energy.
Big man.
Uh-huh.
All right, so it's a real one, all right.
The other thing that I wanted to comment on is that I'm a former teacher and I am married to a teacher. And what the lady just said in Sarasota is absolutely true about the children who pass through the schools. We have a problem here in this county, because I'm calling from Hernando County. We have an awful lot of children moving in from every state in the Union, particularly the Northeast, and a lot of them were uprooted suddenly, dropped down in this community. They are bitter, they're resentful because they are away from their friends. They have no cohesiveness. Now, that's a problem with a lot of schools, is that children come in rapidly, and they may have grown up in one area. They move, they're dropped down into another. The parents are pretty much at sea as much as the children are, because they've come down looking for a better life. And very often you bring your problems right along with you, so you don't necessarily find a better life.
But that's not something really you can deal with.
But we're supposed to, you see.
Oh,
that's
you
the
got
problem.
To, Jim. This is a very, very transient. It's a very new state. You just moved here. You're one of them.
Absolutely. And I've got some comments on stress here, too, in a minute.
Yeah.
About the education. I'm a former teacher,
well,
too.
Well, evidently you're not feeling any, though, because in your throne report, the most stress you had was a guy trying to bum 96 cents off of you.
Yeah, you know, everything is relative.
Yeah.
you get stressed out when your relatives come down.
Well, thanks a lot for sharing that with us. Appreciate that. It's 7:43 at your QZoo in the morning. We're talking about a study, in case you've just tuned in Psychology Today, which deals with this area, the St. Petersburg, Clearwater, and Tampa area, in terms of stress. And one of the big high causes of stress in this area is education. And we're trying to figure out why there's such a high stress level in the school system. Seems there were some valid comments just a while ago. I think we ought to start back there and start from scratch.
The site, QZoo University in Butuan, Virginia. While drilling some 40 miles below the Earth's crust, a substance is discovered that has been defined as the basic unit of all matter. The miracle of scratch. What is scratch?
Well, I make all my buttermilk biscuits from scratch.
Yeah, I rebuilt my car from scratch.
You've heard about it all your life.
It's Rise and Shine biscuit made up every morning fresh from scratch.
I made these brownies from scratch.
Here's Russian exchange, Professor. Hurry up and drop off on scratch.
And I'm Mac.
Which translated means...
What the hell is that?
Here's Vice President George Bush.
The U.S. has learned that scratch is being used in the making of the MX missile, the Midget Man, and what have
Tune in next time for the miracle of What Have You.
This message sponsored by the QZoo Council on Scratch. What Have Yous, Who's Its, and Whatchamacallits.
October.
Once in this land, not that long ago, there was a wild and crazy guy who, like most of us, had to live on a strict, if not limited, budget and found himself in need of transportation. Oh, he tried just about everything to make do, but alas, none worked. For there was a fair maiden to impress. What is a wild and crazy guy to do? The problem needed some serious thought. So like any thinking man would do, the wild and crazy guy turned to Plaza Dodge, US 19 and Holiday, because he had heard that they would beat the pants off any deal. Plaza Dodge had it all. New sporty cars, sedans, and vans, all backed by the famous Chrysler warranty. There's even a wide range of fine used cars to choose from and a full service department to ensure customer satisfaction. Today, our wild and crazy guy may not be so wild or crazy, but he does have his fair maid and a new Plaza Dodge. Plaza Dodge, 1925 U.S. 19 in Holiday. We'll beat the pants off any deal.
Ray, I have a wheelchair here that came from space.
You're kidding, Isaac.
Nope. Try and lift it.
Oh, it's light as a feather.
Well, perhaps a heavy feather. It's made from super light material developed for space vehicles. Weighs half what a standard chair weighs, and it's just as strong.
Must be a lot easier to maneuver, fold, and stow away.
Exactly.
Well, on that note, I'd say it's another down-to-earth benefit from space.
Space technology.
This is what's in it for you.
Think about this. If every one of us gave just 5 hours a week to the causes we care about, it would be like mobilizing more than 20 million full-time volunteers just to tackle the problems of our society. We could all but wipe out drug abuse, juvenile crime, illiteracy, all those things we keep hoping will go away without our help. Just 5 hours a week. But it has to start with somebody, so give five. What you get back is immeasurable.
Dummies crashing our crew, busting our heads just for you.
My name is Vince. This job makes me sore. If you'd buckle up, I wouldn't do it no more.
They call me Larry. I'm a dummy too. When you don't buckle up, the dummy is you.
Buckle that belt.
These are professional dummies. Do not attempt this at home.
Buckle that belt. Don't want one thing to say, and we know we're not wrong. When you go for a ride, put your safety belt on.
Right here at your Q Morning Zoo, we have an answer on Bill Conley's trivia question for George Michael Kunzer tickets. Who is this?
It's Andrea Messina.
All right. What was Olive Oil's shoe size?
14, 6 triple A.
6 triple A.
That's right.
That's a narrow foot.
6 A's after a 14. Yeah, she did.
Congratulations to you. You're going to see George Michael in concert. What is the phrase that pays?
205 means music and money.
Hi, this is Mike Love.
And this is Bruce Johnston.
We're the Beach Boys.
And you're listening to Cleveland.
And Friends.
On the Q.
Morning Zoo. Zoo.
Good morning from the Q. Morning Zoo. Rise and shine with folks like you. Good morning from the Q. Morning Zoo. Get up with the Morning Zoo Zoo.
It's very interesting to bring up a subject like this on the radio that deals with a whole lot of people. Of course, you got the students in between, you got the parents at home, and you got the teachers at school side.
And you got Jim Reilly in his throne room.
And Jim Reilly in his throne room here, and that makes for all kinds of stress on you. But there's a guy, a PhD, on the phone. He says he is. He's a school counselor. He says stress is coming from parents. I like it. Let's throw it back to the parents now. It's sort of like a basketball game right here, huh? But 19th in the nation, this is just one of the factors here, one of the four factors which puts us 19th in the nation on the high stress level. And we're right in front of New York City at number 20.
Talking about stress level being on the parents, I'm familiar with a Hillsborough County elementary school where the teachers that I have heard about and have run into are all stressed out because the stress is coming from the principal. Mm-hmm. A lot of screaming and hollering in the cafeteria, Cleveland, with a bunch of little kids. Now, we're talking about kindergartners, first and second graders.
Yeah.
The teachers are being forced to scream at these little bitty kids.
So what's different about that? They scream when I was in school.
Yeah, but I mean, you don't shut up a cafeteria full of kindergartners and first graders. I mean, you don't have them so quiet where you hear the little forks drop. Not when I was there.
Sister Mary Elephant does.
Yeah, she does.
My knuckles are sore, buddy. Yeah. She punched me out one day.
Bill Connolly brought up a very interesting point a while ago that the climate has somewhat to do with it. This is a beautiful place to live, but the heat is so intense also.
It gets pretty hot.
It brings a high intense stress level. And of course, the number of people moving in from out of state from different school systems readjusting to ours, which is trying to catch up to them and has been for the past couple of years, also adds to that. So you can see some of those factors present, and not just personality factors, not just the teachers who scream or the deans who give you sour looks when you walk in, but those kinds of things too, and they must feel it as well. By the way, if you've been having trouble locating any entry forms for our Q105 Leroy Selman Cleveland and Friends Barbecue and Rib Cook-Off at the Brandon Blue Festival, just give us a call right here at the radio station. We'll sign you up right here and right now in whatever category you want to be in, because there's $2,000 in prize money. It's all for fun. It's all for free. And it's this Sunday at the Tampa Tribune Q105 Brandon Balloon Festival.
Happy birthday to you from the Q Morning Zoo.
Who's on our list, Bill?
Happy birthday to Karen Knapp, Sweet 16. We got Kathy Willett turning 18 years old. Buccaneer Irvin Randall having a birthday with Jeannie Rivera. I love Allison. Myrna Ebanks having a birthday with Kirk Cameron of Growing Pains. Also, Shan Port, happy 15th for Mom and Dad. Our buddy Dr. Joseph Harlow having a belated birthday. We got Jackie Bezaris, 18 years old. Karen Adams is 38. John Claggett, also Jessica Lee Johnston, hitting big 2 years old. Jean Carol Longo is 39. Happy anniversary to Harden and Peggy Pendergast. Also, new baby DJs Michael Allen Spicola, born 527 yesterday morning, to Catherine and Jody Spicola. Also, Jessica Nicole Carter, born 653 last night, to Stanley and Missy Carter. Jim?
Jason Hyder is the big 13 today. Happy birthday to Anna Moscoto, Gail Martin. Dinah Pernas is 18. John Orony, Henry L. Porter, Harry L. Porter, Evie Lou Nichols from the Phoenix Club, and happy birthday to Mike Lundy from Pam, Brianna, and Scott.
All right, and the St. Petersburg Grand Prix has come up. We're doing a broadcast from there next Friday, and Robert Groff is with us here. We'll be talking about the Grand Prix in the sports cage in a couple of seconds right here at the Q Morning Zoo. It's 7:56, and Bill has another one of those impossible trivia questions. Let's not take an hour and a half on this one.
Gotta make it easier one this time. How much of the world's coffee supply do Americans drink? Now, come on.
How much of the world's coffee supply do Americans drink? That's all we want to know.
A drug money laundering operation is blasted. Women walking along Hillsborough by the airport, beware. And Alan Archer says, clear skies, tanning index 8. Good morning, I'm Pat Brooks.
I'm Roger Schulman, and this is the Wednesday, October 12th edition of your Q News magazine. Now here's Deputy Mike with traffic for the Tire Kingdom Go Patrol.
On the way to check out a reported problem on the Howard Franklin Bridge. This will be eastbound East End. Watch out for that. Collisions in Tampa, 50th Street in Hillsborough, George Road in Memorial, Gun Highway in Sugar Mill, Eisenhower and Spruce blocking some south down there. Very heavy volume on the interstate system. No obstructions to hamper your travel. In Pinellas County, have a car fire to watch out for. Landmark Drive and 580. And some very heavy volume, US 19 southbound. Right now, headed toward the Howard Franklin, Deputy Mike for the Tire Kingdom Go Patrol.
Thank you, Mike. It's 7:58 on our front page. A huge sting operation culminated in Tampa yesterday with the unsealing of indictments against the world's seventh largest banking institution, the Bank of Credit and Commerce International Holdings. Agencies from the United States, Britain, and France spent 2 years infiltrating a multi-million-dollar drug money laundering operation and lured many of the key players to Tampa last weekend by inviting them to a fake wedding, then arresting them. Commissioner of U.S. Customs William Von Raab had a word of warning.
We often see these bumper stickers on your cars. Do you know what your children are doing? Where are your children now? Well, my question for these international bankers is, do you know where your customers are, and do you know what your customers are doing? If you don't, you may be next.
Right now, Hillsborough deputies are looking for two men, possibly working together, who've raped at least 8 women in the area of Hillsborough Avenue behind the Tampa International Airport. Deputies say women walking alone after midnight have been targets of attacks by people coming out of the wooded areas and ditches. Deputies are warning women not to walk alone in that area late at night. It is dangerous.
Tomorrow may be the second most important day in the political careers of George Bush and Michael Dukakis. The most important is, of course, November 8th, Election Day. Tomorrow night's debate is considered a pivotal moment in the presidential campaign.
The Dukakis campaign is in Los Angeles for a full day of preparations and rehearsals for tomorrow's debate. The campaign is cooking. We're coming on strong, said Dukakis, as he spoke to California supporters at a rally late last night.
One of the nice things about debates is that it gets people out from behind the balloons and out of the flag factory, and it forces them to deal with the real issues.
At an earlier event in North Dakota, Dukakis said that Bush is offering America the status quo, but this country is great, he said, because we know we can do better. Richard Davies, ABC News, Los Angeles.
Everybody seems to be at a loss as to why Cuba seized the Tampa Seahorse yesterday. The U.S. registered freighter and 8 people on board are being held in a Cuban port after Cuban authorities claimed it violated their sovereign waters. The merchant ships can deny it. The captain denies it. The ship is carrying the New Zealand America's Cup Challenger for a tour of East Coast cities.
If you think you're sitting around in traffic more than in the past, you're right. A study of state roads and traffic shows that lots of roads are being built and many are above national standards.
On the other hand, Florida is facing problems that are unique to the state or are not shared by many other states across the country, and that is this phenomenal growth of population and traffic. Specifically, between 1979 and 1987, traffic on Florida's roads increased by 50%, while traffic nationwide increased by just 24% in the same time.
And that, according to analyst Sally Thompson, is why we're spending more time sitting in long lines of traffic.
The voice of the Buccaneers, Mark Champion, will have sports. Alan Archer, the forecast after this.